ओके, सो वेलकम टू ऑल माय बिलेवेड स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पार्ट्स ऑफ द यूनिट टू ऑफ योर सिलेबस इन रेड टेक्नोलॉजी, दैट इज द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ इक्विपमेंट्स एंड द क्लीनिंग क्लीनिंग एंड सैनिटेशन। ओके, सो इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव डिस्कस द होमोजेनाइजर प्रोसेस एंड इट यूटिलिटी एंड क्लैरिफिकेशन एंड filtration process. Today I will discuss the remaining part, that is the butter and cheese making equipments. So first of all, you will know that when butter is prepared, basically butter prepared from cream, and this cream basically kept in a equipment. This equipment is called churn. Okay, so here we agitate vigorously and then butter is prepared. So first of all, churning refers to the process of agitation of cream at a suitable temperatures until the fat globules adhere with each other, forming larger and larger mass and leading to almost complete separation of fat and serum. During churning, cream is slowly agitated with the paddles provided in the butter churn, causing it to thickener and break into two parts, that is the butter grain and butter milk. At this stage, cold water at 10 degrees Celsius temperatures is added and agitation continue. Addition of water is necessary to help the cream to break, and hence it is known as breakwaters. The volume of water should not exceed 25% of the total volume of cream. Churning continues until the butter granules are about the size of pea grain. In order to prepare good quality butter, the cream should be possess good churnability. So there is basically number of factors dependent during the churnability. That is the first of all, chemical composition of fats, size of fat globule, viscosity of cream, temperature of cream at churning, fat percentage of cream, acidity of cream, load of churn, nature of agitation, speed of churn, pre-churning holding period. This is a factor depends on the churnability, and we can make the very delicious and better butter from this cream by the churning methods. Okay, now butter trolley, it is similarly trolley butter prepared in the churn require unloading, hence a hygienically designed stainless steel open type trolley is required. The size of trolley should be such that it should accommodate all butter from the churn. If the quality quantity of butter made is less, one may collect butter in other containers. Okay, basically this is the trolley. Now cheese making equipments, these are the cheese vat, knife, car mill, hoops and press, etc. This is required for cheese making. The cheese vat is used for coagulation and cooking and is made of stainless steel. Basically you will learn when you go through the cheese making process. Okay, so here there it is described elaborately. Now this picture you can show the cheese vat. This vat is jacketed, allowing place for circulation of hot water between the inner and outer containers. It may or may not have an agitator as shown in the diagram. During coagulation and cooking, agitator is used for uniform dispersion of coagulant. The whey is drained and the curdle mass is placed in cheese hoops for further mating and drainage of secondary whey. The pressure is applied through a cheese press on these hoops for expansion of whey. Thus the block of curdle mass is obtained. Okay, now ice cream machine equipment, basically ice cream making equipment, there is a lot of equipment. So first of all, when you prepare ice cream, first needed one, this is called basically blending tank. So here we can prepare the ice cream mix. Next is required pasteurizers, one homogenizers, aging vat, where we can keep the ice cream mix at least 40 centigrade for 4 hours for better whipping ability or increase the viscosity. Then it is required freezers. You can show the these pictures. Then freezer, then hardening room and cold room. It is the almost packed equipment for preparing of ice cream. So now focus on the fissures. So here grade expansion type fissures, that is the batch fissures, are the most common units. These are the cylindrical and in shapes with one jacket for refrigerant and the other for insulations. The cylindrical act as an evaporator of a refrigeration systems. All you all know that very elaborately, there is the refrigeration systems, because we know fissures, air conditioners, all the one mechanism, that is the refrigeration systems, all are dependent. Okay, so it is made of stainless steel. Normally this is the this is of 6 kg and 12 kg mix holding capacity. After freezing, the volume of mix gets double at their air gets incorporated. Basically this is called the air incorporation or whipping ability, or we can say the overrun. Basically when we prepare the ice cream mix, 2 kg ice cream, 2 kg ice cream mix, you can get the ice cream 4 kg, because here air is incorporated. This is called the overrun of the systems. So this overrun is incorporated in the inside of the freezers. Okay. Now the mix is agitated by the dasher. The dasher does the two jobs: firstly to remove the frozen mix from the inner shell, and second to agitate the mix such that the mix does not freeze into the solid mass. During agitation, a filtered atmospheric or pressurized air is sent into the mix. The air gets trapped, causing overrun of frozen mass. This increase in volume is called overrun. Okay. Now, evaporator and dryers. All you are very well known in your this is the fourth sem. There are food preservation techniques where we can say it. Basically the principle of dryers, principle of evaporators. So you know that the basically different type of dryers, that is a tray dryer, drum dryer, spray dryer. So here we will discuss only drum dryer and spray dryer. Okay, so first of all, milk evaporator. These are the equipments to concentrate milk, usually up to 40% of total solid. This is done by boiling the milk under vacuum. So when the milk is boiled under atmospheric pressures, it is boiled at 100.5 degrees centigrade temperatures. This temperature is so high, the most of the nutrient will be lost. When the milk is boiled under vacuum, the boiling occurs at much lower temperatures, say around 60 temperatures. At these temperatures, most of the properties of milk are retained while the water gets evaporated. That's why we use evaporators. Batch type milk evaporators, it is the like of storage vat with provision of indirect heating and vacuum. Milk remains in the containers for longer durations. Initially, a larger amount of milk is loaded and slowly the batch gets concentrated. It is the cooled and stored. Since the evaporation occurs under vacuum, the chemical properties of milk remain unchanged and only partial water is removed. Fresh milk is loaded and the heating tubes are submerged. Okay. And now this is the continuous type of evaporators. This is the pictures which is shown in my slide. As the capacity of handling increase, there is need to get concentrated milk out in the continuous manner, also in the batch systems. The milk residence time is very high. It does affect the quality of the product. Long tube type equipments are available in the market. These units are very tall and sophisticated in terms of their operation control. The resistance time of milk during evaporation is very short, that is the usually few seconds only. Thus the product quality is superior. Milk travel from one heat exchanger to another in continuous flow. The flow of milk is such that the velocity of is very high, giving very high rate of heat transfers. Whole system is under vacuum. Okay, so milk flow inside the tube could be either in ranging or in falling manners. Accordingly, the evaporator is named. Another way of classifying is the number of heat exchangers involved. Single, double, or triple, or even multi-stage system are available. Okay. Now, dryer, basically, all you know very elaborately, that is the drum dryer, where drum dryer means where basically conduction heater here happened. It was drum heated indirectly. Basically, this drum is firstly heated, then sample or food sample is poured on it, and then it get evaporated and the product is get from the outside or outer part of the systems. So it has a drum heating Internally, with a high pressure system steam, this drum revolves with a low speed in the direction indicated in the figures. The milk is supplied through feed pipe. It gets filled in between the drums. A layer of milk gets adhered to the surface of drum and it started drying till it reaches the knife. So this knife is called the doctor blade. Okay. The knife scrap out of the thin layer of the drop of the dried flakes into the conveyor. The dried product is taken out, the vapor generated over drum and sucked it out through vapor hood. Milk during drying remains in contact with hot drum and for relative longer, causing denaturation of proteins. Hence, powder obtained from this technique usually contains higher sediments. This powder is most suitable for indigenous milk product manufacturing, such as gulab jam. Now spread air. When we will prepare the skim milk powder, basically spread air is required. All you are know, basically this picture is given here. So here the lots of parts is very important. That is the atomizers, the cyclone separators, exhaust gas and liquid feed. Basically when we prepare the skim milk powder, first of all you have to skim out the fat from the milk, because we know milk contain large particles of fat globules. So when it pass through the atomizers, it can get obstacles. So that's why we have to firstly remove the fat from the milk by the use of clarifier. Then liquid milk is poured into the atomizers and the drying chamber is heated, and this heated moisture, this heated air can easily remove the moisture from the milk, and the dried milk is taken out by the outer part, and the remaining part, that is the impurity there. So this is the collected by the cyclone separators, where we can separate the impurity or foreign materials and the milk product. Okay. Now ghee making equipments. At an industrial scale of manufacturing ghee, kettle as shown in figure is used. It is a double walled hemispherical or cylindrical shape jacket vessel. It has provisional for steam heating at a system steam pressures at of 3.5 kg per centimeter square and condensate outlet, safety valve, pressure gauge, agitator cum, scraper, etc. Since there will be deposited formation of heating surface regular scraping at slow speed, it is required. There is also a product outlet valve for unloading the finished product. The capacity of this kettle range from 50 kg to 100,000 kg. There is also one dial type thermometers to indicate the temperature of the jacket. The temperature is varied during preparation of ghee. Same vat or separate vat may be required for heating the residue and cooling the ghee. For this agitator, it stopped and the product is held overnight, and the residue which settle in the bottom of the filter out. Now, paneer and chhana making equipment. That is the basically when we prepare the paneer and chhana, basically vat is required or press is required. So vat, basically the heating and coagulation purpose of milk is done in the stainless steel vat. The stirring is usually done with a ladle. In case of large cattle, a mechanical agitator is fitted with a motor at the bottom of the one of the side of the vat. A drain valve is provided to drain whey after coagulations. Basically we prepare coagulation process done in the vat. Then after draining the primary whey, the cattle mass is collected in hoops lined with a muslin cloth, and weight is applied. In the traditional method, about 45 kg weight is applied for 15 to 20 minutes to allow secondary whey to drain out of the remaining part of the waters from the whey from the coagulation of the coagulated milk. And the matter block is then cut into pieces and dipped into the chilled water. Thus, the paneer is obtained manually in a batch. Okay. So thank you very much. My last part, there is a sanitation and cleaning purpose. We'll continue by the next slide. So thank you.